little boy came into the kitchen one evening while she was fixing supper and handed her a piece of paper he'd been writing on. And after wiping her hands on an apron, she took it in her hands and she read it, and this is what it said. For mowing the yard, $5. For making up my own bed this week, $1. For going to the store, 50 cents. And playing with little brother while you went shopping, 25 cents. Taking out the trash, $1. And for getting a good report card, $5. And for raking the yard, $2. Total owed, $14.75. Well, she looked at him standing there and expecting, and a thousand memories flashed through her mind. So she picked up the pen and turned the paper over, and this is what she wrote. For the 9 months I carried you, growing inside me, no charge. For the nights I sat up with you, doctor, you pray for you, no charge. Charge, son. When you add it all up, the full cost of my love is no charge.
Praise God. Once again, privilege and honor to be in the house of God, to give him praise, glory, and honor. Truly, we serve an awesome God. And you may hear me sometimes using the word an awesome God, because I believe there's no greater word that we can describe how great God is. And we are so grateful that God has spared our lives and caused us again to be in the land of the living, that we can come to the end of another week and the beginning of a new one. I want to take this opportunity to greet every mother, mothers across the nation, mothers of the New Life Fellowship. Amen. A happy God-centered, Holy Ghost-filled Mother's Day. Truly, there is no word or words that can describe the love of a mother. Amen. How wonderful she is, and how wonderful she has been. And had it not been for our mothers today, we would not have been here. Truly, because they have taken the time to take care of us and to have us being men and women today that can stand in this time and to be able to glorify God. Before we get into our message this morning, we have in our midst Brother Payne, Oliver Payne, amen, and we thank God for him, and we give God praise and glory for him for being here with us. And the Brother Payne have a surprise, amen, to give to the mothers. We don't know what is in his mind, but we know that this is a man that is very versatile in the poems and so forth. So we don't know what he will do for us this morning. However, we want to take this opportunity to welcome to the microphone Brother Oliver Payne as he comes to do his bit. God bless you as he comes, Brother Oliver.
Happy Mother's Day to each and everyone. To mothers everywhere, I pray that today, being your day, you would be experiencing something great. I pray that every child who has a mother alive today would show some kind of appreciation. Maybe you are not able to see her physically because of the conditions, because of the things that is happening with this sickness, this disease all over the world. But somehow you know that she is your mother. Make a call. Send a letter. Do something to make her know that you still appreciate her, even if you are not able to be where she is on this day. I want to do a poem which is dedicated partly to my mother and to mothers all. You were there from the very conception. You made it through the aches, the pain, the tears. You stood the test with steadfast dedication and still continues after so many troublesome years. I haven't always been the child you hoped I'd turn out to be. Yet though I kept on disappointing, not once did you give up on me. I kept on taking you for granted, as with a thinking I broke your heart. But your love to me remained unfailing, as with a complaint you willingly did your part. Today I celebrate by saying, thank you, Mother, for all the great sacrifices you have made. I may not have done it the way you wanted, but I surely appreciate the great part you played. Now, this was a tribute to my own mother, who by God's grace still lives today. I pray that she shall continue living, because I'd have it no other way. And now to you, every other mother, I pray that your children considers you blessed and give you the deserved loving, because a mother's love is, without comparison, the best. And on this note, I want to wish each and every mother who is a part of this assembly in New Life Fellowship Church a happy Mother's Day. I know a lot of you would have hoped to be here today celebrating with us, because we normally, as the men, will celebrate and give you a little token and stuff like that. But we know what's going on, and nonetheless, we pray that by God's grace, next year, everything will be back to normal, and you will, in fact, be shown the great love that we have always been showing to you. Happy Mother's Day. Bless to each and every one of you. Amen.
And what a wonderful rendition here this morning. We really thank God for Brother Payne. Amen. And such remarkable rendition. And I know the mothers have been blessed. Praise God. And we thank God for Brother Payne for having to take the time off to come to exhibit such wonderful qualities and to show forth his talents and to extend his heartfelt appreciation to the mothers, not just of the New Life Fellowship, but to those mothers who are listening to him over this media. Once again, thank you, Brother Payne, and God bless you. Amen. So we give God praise and thanks once again that we can come together to give God the praise, the glory, and the honor. Truly, as I said earlier on, it's a privilege, an honor to come before God's presence to glorify him and to magnify him. I want to be with you just for the next few minutes. Amen. As we share from the Word of God, from the Word of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 31, from verse 10 on to 31. Amen. We know that the Word of God declares, from verse 10 to 31, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of a husband do it safely, trust in her, so that he shall not have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like a merchandise or a merchant ship, she bringeth her food from afar. She riseth up also while he is yet asleep or night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maiden. She considereth and feedeth. She considereth a field, and buyeth it with the fruit of her hands. She planted a vineyard. She girded her loins with strength, and strengthened her arms. She perceived that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She laid her hands to the spingle, and her hands hold it. She stretched out her hands to the poor, yet she reached forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself covering of tempest, her clothing in silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh her fine linen and selleth it, and deliver girdles unto the merchandise, or the merchants, sorry. She strengtheneth and strength and honor are in her color, and she shall rejoice in the time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the way of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call it her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own work praise her in the gate. Father, we thank you for thy word. We give you praise, Lord. Bless thy word to our hearts. Let thy word come alive in our spirit. Bless the listeners today, and cause them, Heavenly Father, to respond to thy word. May thy word, Lord, bring light to those who are in darkness, and cause them to, God, understand that it is time for them to return to God and to know you as Lord and Savior. We thank you for our mothers today. Lord, our mothers in the New Life Church, our mothers in churches, O God, throughout the length and breadth of our country, our mothers, O God, that are listening to us, Father, on this media, may you continue to bless them and strengthen their hearts as they avail themselves to your will. Cover them with your blood, Lord, and cause them to trust you with all their hearts, that they will not lean to their own understanding, but in all of their ways they will acknowledge you, and you will direct their path. Bless thy word today, and bless us In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to speak to you today on the subject, the mother of a noble character. The mother of noble character. You may ask me the question, why do I theme this message? A mother of noble character. Because I believe it is important to understand that mothers are very important. Sometimes we take our mothers for granted. Sometimes we underestimate the wife that we have or the wives that, amen, our men, God has blessed us with, knowing that they have been mothers to us by bearing our children and spending time nourishing, admonishing, and growing them up. I think we must give hats off to our mothers because they are very important and they play a very significant, important role in the life of our children. When I say a woman or mother of a noble character, it is important that we understand what the word noble means. Now, the word noble means showing fine personal qualities or high moral principles and ideas. A woman that is considered to be a noble woman is considered to be righteous. It is considered also to be a virtuous woman, an honorable woman, an honest woman, an upright woman, outstanding or upstanding woman, a decent woman, worthy. She is also a worthy woman, unselfish, generous, self-sacrificing, brave, and courageous. These are the kind of qualities that we describe our mothers to be. Because all of these qualities that I would have made mention of today, you can bear me witness that our mothers can fall under these conditions because they have proven themselves to be women of noble character. We must understand, ladies and gentlemen, that this verse of scripture that I read earlier on describes the idea or the ideal wife and mother, her whole life is centered around, amen, reverence and fear for God. I believe to be a woman of noble character, she must possess fear for God. A mother must not just be one who take care of her household or her children. But she must possess these qualities because it is important. When we have a mother that feareth God, it is very easy for her to train and to nourish her children in the way of God. Because once that mother fears God, amen, she knows exactly how to train her children and how to lead her children in the way of God because she fears God. And when I use the word fear, I mean walking in reverence and respect towards God. This is what it meant to be a woman of noble character. A woman that possesses a noble character, she must fear God. She must walk in the fear of God, because these qualities that I made mention of can only be made eminent in the lives of our mothers when they learn how to fear God, when they learn how to walk in reverence and respect before God and uphold themselves decently and allow God to be the center of their lives, then they are able to release those qualities onto their children, and their children can be able to exhibit those same qualities because they live by examples. It is important that we understand that when we walk in reverence, when the mothers walk in reverence and respect before God, they understand what it is, as the Proverbs would have declared in Proverbs 31 and verse 30. He said, favor is deceit. A woman of noble character, amen, she refuses to receive favors. She is a woman, amen, because she understands that favors is deceit. Hallelujah. And beauty is vain. But the woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. She understood that it is important to fear God and refuse to accept favors, because favors always have something behind it that maybe will not, she may not want to, amen, destroy her reputation or her character, but she wants to stand as a woman of God and be able to exhibit the qualities that will bring great results in the end, that will give God praise and glory. A woman of noble character understand that favors is deceit. Because most times when one offers you favors, they always have, amen, some ulterior motive. And a mother, even though she might be left alone to mind her children without the father, she refused to accept favors. She rather work hard with her hands, amen. She rather labor with her hands and to earn something of a genuine motive where she can be able to testify to her children in spite of the struggles that she might have gone through or been through in life. She's able to tell her children of the struggles that she would have been through, yet she would have maintained her integrity, and she refused to accept favors, amen, with amen having to give back something that she refused, because it would have caused her to compromise her standards. And a woman of virtuousness, a woman, amen, a virtuous woman, a woman of noble character will not bring herself to that standard where her character, amen, and her standard will be compromised. I'm here to speak to every mother this morning. Hats off to you, to those of you who have made the time to sacrifice and to make sure that your children have the next bread to eat. You would not have lowered down your character. You would not have, amen, lowered your standard, amen, in all order to mind your children. And even though some of you would have caused yourself to compromise your standard, I still lay hats off to you, amen, because you would have seek, amen, in order to maintain the best for your children. You would have gone the extra mile. But the Bible says, favor is deceit, but the woman that feareth God shall be praised. And I want you to know that in times of hardship, you need to fear God. You see, when you walk in reverence and respect towards God, and you know that God is there and that God promised to supply all your needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus, you refuse to lower your standard. You refuse to bring yourself to that standard. You hold yourself up in high esteem. And I'm speaking to those of you mothers out there, amen, that sometimes it moves you, amen, sometimes needs, amen, and desires to provide for your children will move you to compromise your standards. But I'm calling upon you to hold up your integrity, because God has not forgotten you. God said he shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. And I'm saying to you, trust God. He will not forsake you, but he will be there in times of need. Yes, sir. A woman or a mother of noble character understand by humility, hallelujah, and the fear of the Lord are riches and honor and life. So when you humble yourself before God, when you allow God to know your conditions and you submit yourself to him and you fear him, amen, which means that there is a standard in which you as a mother has set for yourself, and you refuse to lower that standard, amen, for anyone to compromise your integrity, to compromise your character and reputation. You refuse to bring yourself to such condition. You maintain that level, amen, of moral integrity, and you tell yourself that God, I fear you and I love you. You know, God, that I want to be able to serve you. And once you purpose that in your heart, God will meet your needs at the point, amen, of desperation. I know sometimes you have become desperate, because when the children is crying and there is nothing to supply, I'm here to declare to you, God will not forsake you. God said, I will not leave you nor forsake you. Amen. The word of God said, amen, to call on me and I will answer thee, and I will show thee great and mighty things that thou knowest not of. A woman of noble character stands firm and maintain her integrity and desire to walk in God and to fear God. God will not disappoint you. He will supply everything you so desire. You must understand that this is what God is saying to you. Humility and the fear of the Lord are riches. So you see where your riches come from? Humbling yourself, fearing God, and then blessings follow. Is riches the Lord? Amen. There are riches and honor. When you fear God, people honor you. Amen. Not just honor you, but God also honors you. And God give you life. Hallelujah. And without life, you cannot make it. And so we need God in this time. where our life can be extended. So for that to happen, so that we can be able, amen, you ladies can be able to see your children grow up and become women and men of tomorrow, you need to walk in the fear of God. Don't you dare let down yourself. Even though you have need and you don't know where the next dollar is coming from, you maintain your integrity. Walk with your head high. Amen. Refuse to allow men to abuse you and misuse you. You let God know your needs and walk before God. Amen. As a woman of integrity, a woman that is virtuous. Hallelujah. It is important that you understand humility and fear. Humility and fear of the Lord bring wealth and honor. And I'm telling you this, I'm reading this from another version. Amen. And that is Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 4. Amen. Humility and fear of the Lord, it brings wealth and honor and life. So if you are looking for something to maintain your home, the secret in getting God to respond to you is to walk in fear towards God. Humble yourself, the Bible says, under the mighty hands of God, and he will exalt you. When you humble yourself and fear the Lord, wealth comes. Wealth and honor and life will come to you. A woman of noble character will learn how to fear God, how to honor God, how to humble ourselves before God, and she will experience the blessings of God upon her life. It is important, the fear of the Lord. Hallelujah. The fear of the Lord. Added length to life. But the years of the wicked are but short. Are you with me? When we fear God, it adds length to your life. But when you compromise your standards, it shortens your life. God is saying to you mothers, continue to hold up your integrity. Continue to be a noble woman, a woman or a mother of noble character. Continue to maintain those standards. Hallelujah. We must understand, a woman of noble character, she shows forth certain qualities. She has compassion for those in need. That is a woman of noble character. She has compassion. Hallelujah. For those in need. In other words, a woman of noble character does not just care for her own household, but she cares for other people's children. That's a woman with a noble character. That's a mother, amen, that concerns. She does not just care about those of her household only, but she looks out for those, amen, on the outside, those who are in need, which she is concerned about them. In other words, you know what a woman or a mother with noble character do or does. Whenever the husband bring home, amen, food stuff or monies to buy groceries, that woman of noble character, she will hide something somewhere and said to the children, go bring this to the neighbor, because she know that that neighbor have a great need. Are you with me? That's a woman or a mother with a noble character. Sometimes a husband does not even know it. And that's what the Bible says, that what your right hand knows, don't let your left hand know. Are you with me? What your right hand knows, don't let your right left hand knows. It is important that we understand that mothers with noble character, amen, they look out for those who are in need, not just a household, but for those, her neighbors and friends. Hats off to you, mothers. Hats off to you. The Bible says, and the mother knows that in Deuteronomy 15 and verse 11, there will always be people in the land. Therefore, I command you to be open-handed, hallelujah, towards your brothers and towards the poor and needy in your land. Yes, mothers, some of you mothers are concerned about those who are in need. And the Lord is saying that there will be poor people among you. And sometimes, amen, we don't even understand. The neighbor does not have something to eat. But mothers always understand the importance and the desperateness of others. Amen. And so they will send something over the gate and say, give this to the neighbor, because they're concerned about others who are in need. And when we have mothers of noble character, they are concerned about those who are in need. They are concerned about those who need. Are you with me? They are concerned about those, praise God, who lack something. And God said, be open-handed, which means don't hold it tight. There are some of you, you're very tight. You're mingy. Amen. You're stingy. But God is saying, when you bless, God will bless you in return. It is important that we understand the importance of these people and reach out to them. A mother of noble character understands it is important to earn her own living. It is important to have her own. She don't believe in stealing another person's, amen, goods. She don't believe in stealing the neighbor's goods. She believe in laboring with her hands. Amen. She believe in earning her own. She believe in working hard. Even though it meant that she had to go, amen, and clean the street. Our mothers will always reach out and provide for her children. The Bible said in Ephesians 4:28, let him that steal or stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may have to give to him that have need. God expect a woman of noble character to give to those who are in need, so that such person will not steal, amen, anymore. They'll be able to have something to go by. And sometimes people cannot help it. That's why they steal. That's why they rob. That's why they take what is not theirs, because they have to provide for their children. And so I am saying to you that as long as you learn how to trust God, as long as you learn how to believe God, as long as you learn how to depend on God, you will not have to steal anymore. But God will give you what it takes to labor with your hands in order to earn something. Amen. To give to others. Bible says that a noble woman, she displays faith. Fullness and love towards her family. This is the noble woman. She displays a certain quality to her children. Hallelujah. Faithfulness. Yes, sir. Faithfulness towards her children. Love. Because without love in the home, our children grew up without love. And we notice that when they grew up in a home without love, that same quality or qualities is being exhibited in their homes when they have a family. But a mother understands the importance of exhibiting love and showing loyalty and faithfulness to her children so that they can emanate the same lifestyle and they too can be able to show it towards their children. And the mother does not just do that for their children, but they also do it for others. Hallelujah. They do it to others. They exhibit those qualities to others because they understand how important it is for others to have those qualities. A mother of noble character understand the importance of showing that love towards her children. It is important that you and I, the Bible says, when she do those things, in verse 27 of Proverbs, chapter 31, she looketh well to the way of a household and eateth not the bread of idleness. Yes, sir. In other words, she provide. She will not eat the bread of idleness. And so a woman of noble character have no time to idle. She makes time, even though she does not have a husband. She makes sure that the five children that she has in her possession, she provides for them. She has no time to idle. She makes sure that her children have a meal to eat. Amen. Tea, breakfast, and dinner. It is important that we understand. She look well. Yes, sir. And she do not eat the bread of idleness. She's not a slothful woman. Hallelujah. But she make things work. When a person is idle, they suffer hunger. And a woman of noble character understands the importance of not having her children suffer hunger. Bible says in Proverbs 19, verse 15, lazy people sleep soundly, but idleness leave them hungry. When we find ourselves idling, when you can find yourself doing something of importance, the final analysis of this is hunger. But a woman of noble character has no time for idleness. That woman understands the secret, and she make time to serve God. It is important that when we praise God, ladies, when you praise God in the rightful place in your home and in your family, you will not suffer hunger. When God becomes the center of your life, the center of your family life, a woman of noble character brings her family together and prays together. Amen. A family that prays together stays together. She understands how important it is to serve God. When she serves God, she's able to serve her family. She's able to serve others. Because it is important to serve God. You see, without God, we have no sense of direction. Without God, a noble woman or a woman of noble character will not have any sense of direction. She understands and understood the importance of God being in the center of their life. So she allowed God to dictate her every move, to direct her in every decision making, a woman of noble character. She understands that if I should leave God out of the picture, then I would not be able to be the mother that I ought to be. If God is not in the midst of her life, she understands with the ability and the moral resources that God has given to her, she would not be able to distribute it wisely. So a woman of noble character understands what she has. She needs God in every aspect of her life to be able to distribute what God has given to her. Because sometimes what the mother would have had in her home, it is so limited that she don't know how to share it among her children. But when she call on God and she asks God to bless it and to multiply it, then it becomes sufficient. And she's able to distribute it, and all of her children would be fed and go to bed with their bellies filled. Hats off to you mothers. Amen. We know that what you're doing is a hard task. What you have been doing is not easy. But with God on your side, you are able. Some of you would have left without a husband. Some of you would have left without the man in your life who would have given you so many of the children that you have now. And you have to saddle for yourself. Yet you would have made it today. Some of your children have made men, have become men and women. And I'm saying to you, children, who your mothers have suffered, amen, and caused you to be where you are, don't you be ungrateful to your mothers. Don't be ungrateful to your mothers. Treat them, amen, with respect and hold them in high esteem, because your blessings depend on it. I am calling upon you, young men and women, hold your mothers in high esteem. You don't know the struggles they would have gone through just to have you where you are. And those of you who would have taken the opportunity to curse your mothers, to curse and say all manner of things to your mothers, amen, say all manner of hurtful things to your mothers, I am calling upon you to go to your mothers and repent, because your days will be hard. Repent, because your mothers, amen, do not deserve the way you are treating them. They would have made time to make sure that you had a proper education, that you have gone to the best and finest school. They would have sucked salt to make sure that you have what you earn today. And after this, you will turn around, amen, and disregard your mother and treat her as though she's nobody. Hear me, I am calling on you to repent, because it may seem as though you are flourishing now, but your days will be few. I am calling upon you to repent and return to your mothers and ask them to forgive you. For the Bible says, honor thy mother and thy father, that your days will be long in the land. You disobey your mothers, if you rebel against your mothers, you are opening doors for serious disaster ahead of you. You may feel that you are making headway for now, but you don't realize that the time is coming, that the seed you sow, you will reap the same. What you sow is what you will reap. Your children will treat you the same way you treat your mother. For you to stop it, you need to stop it now and go back to your mother and ask your mother to forgive you, amen, and amen, to release you, so that the curse will not fall onto your generation and to your future generation. But you can stop it right there by going to mommy and ask her, mommy, I have sinned against you, please forgive me. Your mother would have sucked salt to make sure that you're where you are today. A woman of noble character, when you treat her bad, the tears that come from her eyes will affect your future. But you can stop that, young man. You can stop that, young woman. You can stop that from passing on to another generation by going to your mother and ask her to forgive you for the way you treat her. She didn't deserve that. Probably she would have made a mistake, but that does not mean that she deserved the way you are treating her. Probably what you asked her for, she did not give you. But that does not mean that you, amen, have to treat her the way you're treating her. Amen. She did not abort you. She did not kill you in childbirth. She brought you forth. Or probably after she brought you forth, she would have given you up for adoption, because she believed that you would have had the best life, because in her position, she would not have been able to provide for you. That does not mean that she did not love you. Go back to your mother and find your mother and ask her to forgive you, because it is important that you understand that woman is your mother and she loves you. In spite of what? It is important to understand that a woman of noble character She understands how important it is to provide for the home, to make her husband proud of her, to allow her husband to walk with his head up, because she's a woman of integrity. A woman of noble character is a woman of integrity. Bible says, beauty is vain. Favor is deceit. But the woman that feared the Lord shall be great. When you understand that it's more than just looking at yourself in a mirror and making yourself nice, that is good. But it is important that you learn how to fear God, and everything else follows after that. When you learn how to fear God, everything else follows or falls in place. A woman's highest position and true dignity is in the home. A woman of noble character submits herself to her husband, because she understands that the secret is right there. Submitting herself to her husband, you do it as unto the Lord. So when you walk in obedience to God's word as a woman of noble character, it blesses her and causes her to walk in God's word. So a woman's highest possession or position and true dignity is in the house or in the home as a godly wife and mother. No greater joy, inner delight, blessings or honor can come to her than when, amen, as a Christian wife and mother, she bear her children. She love her children. A woman of noble character love her children. Amen. She loved them. She raised them up to live for Christ. That's a woman of noble character. She wants her children to have the best. And a lot of time we tell, amen, parents or even mothers say to themselves that the best thing that I can give my child or my children is a proper education. But the best thing you can give your child, amen, is a God-centered life. So a woman of noble character train up her child in the way of God and teaches them how to live for God. Once that is in place, everything else falls in line. She teaches them how to live for God. That is a woman of noble character. And as I said earlier on, a noble woman, or the word noble, having or showing fine personal qualities. And these are the qualities that we can find in a woman of noble character. Having fine and personal qualities or high moral principles. When you have a woman with a level, amen, of principle, a high level of principle, which means she's saying to herself, I refuse to come down, amen, and to subdue or to compromise my principles or my standards in which I have set. And when you set those moral principles, you expect your children also to align themselves to it. And this is a woman of noble character. Amen. She's a virtuous woman. The Bible says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is beyond rubies. You see, we need to understand that a virtuous woman is very important. It is very important to find a virtuous woman. And these are the days, sometimes it is hard for us to find a virtuous woman. But when you do find a virtuous woman, men, you need to cherish them. When you can find not just a mother for your children, but a woman that can be considered virtuous, the Bible says her price is beyond rubies. Which means a virtuous woman, there is no price that can be, amen, given to her. She's beyond any price that you can even imagine. A woman of noble character, there's no price that you can place in her possession. So she is a virtuous woman. She's also an honorable woman. People honor her in the community, in the surrounding. People honor her. She's considered to be an honest woman. People can trust her. That is a woman of noble character. She can be trusted. Her husband can trust her. Her children can trust her. Her neighbors can trust her. Amen. Her workplace can trust her. Because she's considered to be a virtuous woman. A woman of noble character. She's upright. She keeps herself to a certain standard. Amen. She's upright. She's a decent woman. Amen. She conducts herself in a respectable manner. Not bringing herself and doing any crazy things like some mothers today. Some of you mothers, the way you dress, you degrade, amen, your children. You degrade yourself. You lower your standards. You need to be mothers. You need to stand up like mothers. You cannot want to dress like your children. It is important that you set standards. It is important that you be who you're supposed to be. Your children is looking up to you. Your children, amen, is counting on you. Some of you dress slack, amen. You're naked on the streets. You need to maintain, amen, a certain decorum that your children can respect you. It is important that you understand this. A woman of noble character is a decent woman. Yes, sir. She's not just decent, but she's worthy. She's also an unselfish person. A woman of noble character. Hallelujah. She's not selfish. She does not think of herself. Herself only. She think of others. Amen. She's not selfish. She considered, amen, there are other people who are hurting. There are other people who are desperately in need. Are you there? And when you show unselfishness, glory to God, as a mother, it causes your children to praise you and to lift you up because you are considered to be a mother of great value, a woman of noble character. It is important that you understand. She's not just unselfish. But as I said earlier on, she's also a generous woman. Nothing is too hard for her to give. Nothing is too big for her to give. Nothing is too much for her to give. Nothing is too little for her to give a bit out of it because she's considered a noble woman, a woman of noble character. She is not selfish. She is generous. A woman of noble character. She's willing to sacrifice herself for her children. Amen. She's self-sacrificing. She gave everything. Amen. A woman of noble character. Sometimes all that she have in the house, she rather do without and make sure that her children have it to eat. That's a woman of noble character. Hats off to you, mothers. Hats off to you. Amen. I praise you, mothers, because, amen, you have done great. May God bless you. Amen. Amen. You would have made sacrifices so that you and I, we can be here today. Amen. My mother is not here today, but hats off to her. Hallelujah. Because she would have made sacrifices to have me where I'm at today. I thank God for my mother. Amen. A woman of noble character. Self-sacrificing. Provide when we didn't have. Give us when all there was. Amen. Left. Make sure that we have. And she stayed without. Oh God. To God be the glory. And may hats off to these mothers. And to my mother who was past and gone. But I pray to God she's somewhere with the Lord. It's important that we understand that we need to cherish our mothers. And you know, sometimes we don't know what we have until we lose it. Yes, sir. Amen. We don't know what we have until we lose it. We don't understand how important mothers are to us. A woman of noble character. She's brave. She's not afraid to go into any crowd to make a living for her children. She's not afraid to assemble anywhere or to plow her hands, no matter where, just to make a dollar to make sure that her children, she allows herself to die. And she's brave enough to go out there and bring in a dollar. And finally, she's a woman of great courage. And I'm here to declare to you, mothers, continue the good work. Continue what you have been doing. We cannot finish repay you. We will never be able to repay you. But as long as you're alive, our duties are to make sure that we make you happy. And I'm calling upon young men and young ladies. Love your mothers. Cherish your mothers. Appreciate your mothers. Amen. Let them know how much you love them. If ever so often, call them. Even though you're not living with them, call them. Let them know how much you appreciate the hard work they have done for you. Amen. And cause you to be here. Some of you saying, I don't owe my mother nothing. Yes, you owe everything. Because had not been for her, and the sacrifices that she made, you would not have been here. I trust God today that you will come to grips with your life and understand that a mother's love is so important that no money in the world can purchase it. Continue to love your mother, your mothers. Continue to love, amen. Love them with all your heart. But for you to do so, you must learn to love God. When you love God, you will find your mother and repent and love her the way you ought to love her. I trust God that you will continue to avail yourself. And this Mother's Day, make sure that you make your mother, amen, feel happy for this Mother's Day and all the other Mother's Day to come. And as a matter of fact, every day should be Mother's Day. I trust God that you will continue to enjoy your Mother's Day. All mothers, may God bless you. May God keep you. May God cause his face to shine upon you and grant you his peace. I pray for strength. I pray for endurance. And those of you mothers who are grieving because of your children, put it in the hands of God. He's going to turn it around. God bless you and enjoy your Mother's Day. Have a productive day. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you.